Hit it.
I'm here to tell you that you are indeed the true kings and queens of the earth. But being brought to this wicked country, they have reduced us to whores and bees and the N-word. But we come out here to tell you that you are much greater than that. Much, much greater than that. You come from the stocks of kings and queens, from Moses, David, Solomon, and so forth and so on, and all the greats. And the one that the world calls Jesus, you come from him. We are the children of Israel. We represent the chosen seed, and that's what we come out here to let our people know. So I'm going to say Shabbat Shalom, my beautiful black people. Know who you are. That's what we come out here to let y'all know, who you are according to these scriptures. But we are suffering under these curses that is written off in the Old Testament, Deuteronomy 28 and Leviticus 26. We are written off, it was prophesied that we would come across the world in cargo slave ships and be brought to the other side of the world. We would lose our heritage, our identity, our language, our culture, everything that we've ever known about ourselves. It was written that we would forget it and be stripped of it. So we're going to walk through some of these scriptures to show it to you. We are indeed living under these curses written off in the Old Testament. Give me Deuteronomy 28. But we indeed are a special people, a chosen people. This is why we're the best at everything. We just don't own it, because the wicked behind the scenes control it. But we are indeed the greatest at everything. As soon as a half of our person get in it, we take it over. Tiger Woods is a cobbling Asian. Half, but he still took it over. Yeah, we went to that.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 1. And it shall come to pass, if you shall listen diligently.
If you do what?
If you listen diligently.
If you listen diligently to me, read.
To the voice of the Most High your God. To observe and to do all his commandments.
To observe and to do all of what?
All his commandments.
Now in these last days we got people teaching us that we don't have to keep the commandments. He came and died for, but he already told you, I change not. So if he's saying right here, it still stands to this very day. Read.
Which I command you this day, that the Most High, your power, will set you on high.
Do what?
Will set you on high.
He will set you on high. Read.
Above all nations.
Equal with everybody.
Above all nations.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. He says above all nations. Is that, are you messing that up, or does it really say above?
The Most High will set you high above all nations.
Wait a minute. In this thing, they say over here, they say all men are created equal. But this says something else. Read it one more time.
And the Most High, your God, will set you on high above all nations.
Above all nations. That's written right there in the book. Read.
But it shall come to pass if you will not listen.
If you what?
If you will not listen.
So if you don't listen, it's a stipulation in this. If you will not listen, read.
Unto the voice of the Most High, your power, to observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command you this day.
But you what?
That all these curses shall come upon you and overtake you.
That all of these curses shall come upon you and they will overtake you. So we're going to run you through just a couple of the curses and show you that this is talking about you, so-called black man and black woman. Chapter 32.
Verse 32. Your sons and your daughters shall be given unto another people, and your eyes shall look and fail with longing for them.
If you go back and you watch Roots, or you go into the Atlantic slave trade, you will see this right here being fulfilled. Read that again, my heart.
Verse 32. Your sons and your daughters shall be given unto another people.
Your sons and your daughters shall be given unto another people. There's not another people on the face of the earth that this has taken, that this has happened to on such a large scale. Read.
And your eyes shall look and fail with longing for them.
Even though we physically the most strongest people, we couldn't do absolutely nothing about it. It says your eyes shall look and fail with longing. So you play it back in your mind in Roots when they sold Kizzy. And Kuta and his wife was just laying on the ground crying, oh my God, I'm taking my baby. Your eyes shall look and fail with longing for them, because you can't do absolutely nothing about it. And they still doing it on another way right now. They locking your black kids up in these jails, and the mother and the father eyes is looking and failing with longing, watching this thing. Read.
And there shall be no might in your hand.
Read on.
The fruit of your land and all your labors shall a nation which you know not eat you up.
Shall a nation which you know not eat you up. Read.
And you shall be only oppressed and crushed always.
Ain't that what's happening to the so-called black man and woman?
Yes, indeed.
Oppressed always, no matter what. You can't get ahead for absolutely nothing, because we are oppressed and crushed always. Read.
So that you shall be mad for the sight of your eyes.
That's why young men walk around sagging, mad all day long. Older people scared to pull up to the gas station because they standing outside mad. Walking over people. Scared of our own people because they walking around mad, just like the scripture says.
Read. Verse 36. The Most High shall bring you and your king, which you shall set over you, unto a nation which neither you nor your fathers have known.
So he's going to bring you to a nation neither you nor your fathers have known. Guess where that nation is at? So-called America. So-called South America. So-called Canada. North, Central America. All of these different places he brought you that we didn't know nothing about. Read.
And there you shall serve other gods.
So you shall do what?
You shall serve other gods.
You shall serve Jesus and Baal and Allah. All of these different fake gods, you shall serve them in this place. Read.
Wood and stone.
Wood and stone. That cross is made of wood, and that Kaaba stone over there in Mecca that our people is worshiping. Look at 37.
Verse 37. And you shall become an astonishment.
Shall be what?
You shall become an astonishment.
That's why our people walk around and other nations look at them and they're astounded. Like the guy riding that thing. People are looking at him, astounded at him. How is he balancing himself on one wheel? They're astounded. I'm just there when they see other people. Same exact way. Read.
A proverb and a byword.
A proverb and a byword. The proverb, eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Catch a nigga by the toe. If you holler, that's a proverb. And it says a byword. Now what's that byword that we so proudly embrace to this day? We had a group come out in the 90s called NWA. What that stand for?
It stands for Niggas With Attitudes.
Niggas With Attitudes. So this is that great byword. But let's see if it's recorded in our scriptures that this thing will come to pass. Because we're the only backwards people that took slave food, now we call it soul food, and make it like it's something good. We used to call a woman a B-word, she'd be mad as the devil at you. Now she call her own self the B-word. I'm the baddest B you ever gonna see. Can't none of them B's do it like me. Straight foolishness, right?
The book of Acts, chapter 13 and verse 1. Now there were in the church that was at Antioch certain prophets and teachers, as Barnabas and Simeon.
Certain prophets and teachers. Now let's see what these people called them.
That was called nigger.
That was called what?
That was called nigger.
Wait a minute. So that's recorded in the scriptures way back then? But there's nothing new under the sun. If they was doing it then, they're doing it now, because history does what? It repeats itself. Get back to them coaches. Read.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 41. You shall beget sons and daughters.
You shall beget sons and daughters, read.
But you shall not enjoy them.
You're not going to enjoy them, because guess what? They're going to be locked up or dead. Read.
For they shall go into captivity.
They're going into captivity. And we see it every day on the news. For the smallest thing, he can have three rocks, and the so-called white man can have a kilo of cocaine. Guess who getting the most time? The so-called black man. Something ain't right about this system. It's set up against you, my people. Read.
Verse 43. The stranger that is within you shall get up above you very high.
So, okay, let's take Detroit, right? Detroit is so-called like 80% so-called black man, right?
Right.
Like 80%. So the strangers that's around us would be who?
The strangers would be the so-called Arab man that runs your gas stations. The so-called Korean and Japanese that run your beauty salons or beauty supply stores. So on and so forth. The fake Jew that runs the financial systems where you gotta go cash a check or borrow a few dollars for a payday advance. Absolutely. These are the other nations that surround you, so-called black man.
So these are the strangers that are around you. And it says they shall get above you very high. Read.
And you shall come down very low.
That's exactly what's taking place. Our people is very low. We don't own nothing in our own city. Only two things that we might have any ownership in is a barber shop and maybe a car wash. And an Arab normally go behind the scenes owning that.
Or, unfortunately, most of our brothers then purchase that with drug money, not getting it righteously.
How you doing, brother? Well, I mean, you got any questions that you want to ask direct?
Oh, no. I've seen y'all out here before. I know a little bit about the Honorable Elijah Muhammad and the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan.
But check this out real quick, brother. We don't, to be honest with you, we're not Muslim. Okay. We Israelites, okay? And in 2010, Minister Farrakhan came out and put out a teaching that went out to the world, where he announced to the earth that the so-called black man is the true Israelite according to scripture.
That's right.
So now, this guy who stands on the podium of Islam then opened up the door to let people know, okay, hey, they people of the book, right? But then he's standing there holding, what would he hold right there in his hand right there, brother? You know what that is? Yeah, that's the Quran, right? But the children of Israel, like, you know, we know we go back to are written of in the scriptures. Even the Quran tells you to go back and check out these scriptures right here.
Right.
So what's going on here? Something ain't right in the mix. It's just something for you to think about.
Exactly.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Have a good day.
You too,
all right,
brother.
Let's get back into it.
Verse 44, he shall lend to you, and you shall not lend to him.
He shall lend to you, and you shall not lend to him, because we don't own anything to lend anybody anything. But like he said, the fake Jewish folks is behind the loans, charging you 30% or something, which the Bible tells you you're not supposed to charge usury. And they're directly breaking that. But we know our people don't read the book, so you're not aware of that. We?
He shall be the head, and you shall be the tail.
That's why he owned the business. That's why you last hired, first fired. That's why all of these things is popping off. Because you are the tail and he is the head. We, I should say. All because we didn't want to listen and we want to follow the other nations and do what they say, do what they do. We want to follow behind them. But all of them really wants to be like you. They tell you that they hate you, but they inject their lips with all of this foolishness. They tell you that they hate your black skin, but they sit out in the sun and cook themselves. Go to tanning salons and lay up under the steam and burn themselves up just to look like you. Say, we hate that. We want to be like Jane Fonda, but look what they doing. They inject this stuff in their behinds to try to look just like you.
Verse 45. Moreover, all these curses shall come upon you and pursue you.
And do what?
And pursue you.
So it don't matter where you go, they're going to do what?
Pursue you.
They're going to pursue you. It doesn't matter where you go on the face of this earth. If you ain't keeping his law, statutes, and commandments, these things is chasing you. They're going to pursue you. They coming after you. Worse than these wicked cops. Read.
Because you listen not.
Because you did what?
You listen not.
You is hard-headed. And what they say about a hard head, what do it make?
A soft behind.
A soft behind. I should be so soft, it's like one of this Kim Kardashian or somebody. Because we so hard-headed.
We? To keep his commandments and his statutes which he commands you. And they shall be upon you for a sign.
And they said what?
Be upon you for a sign.
They shall be upon you for a sign. Or a mark. Mm-hmm.
And for a wonder, and upon your seed forever.
Forever. This is how we identify ourselves, because this sign and this wonder is on the children of Israel. And this is the identifying mark that shows you who you are. Because he didn't put this on nobody else. And some teach them, well, the other people went into slavery with you, but it's not prophesied for them. It's prophesied for you, so-called black man and black woman. Hmm?
Therefore, shall you serve your enemies.
Shall you do what?
Serve your enemies.
Shall you serve your enemies. Now, without even pointing them out, you know who your enemies is. You know who's doing all of this wicked stuff to you. You know who hangs your people in trees. You know who beat you to a pulp. You know who's still locking you up. You know who's doing these things, but it says, and there you shall be served unto your enemies, or serve your enemies. Read.
With which the Most High shall send against you.
So he sent these people against us because we broke the laws, statutes, and commandments. So if you don't keep these, he sent these people against you. So you can't even blame him. He's just doing his job. Read.
In hunger and in thirst.
In hunger and in thirst. So when you're hungry, guess what? You go to your enemy for it. We don't own no grocery stores. When you need clothing, you go to your enemy, because we don't own Macy's or any of these fancy places that we like to shop at. But we don't own none of them.
Gucci not my friend?
Absolutely not.
Ralph Lauren ain't my friend?
Absolutely not.
What about Macy's?
Absolutely not. Secretly, these guys are some flaming faggots behind the scenes, trying to get you to put on skinny jeans, when you know good and well ain't no black man got no business in those skinny jeans. It's gay as all outdoors. Read.
And he shall put a yoke of iron.
He said, do what?
Put a yoke of iron.
Now I want y'all to pull out them smartphones and Google a yoke of iron. Because we got it right here. But pull out them sophisticated smartphones and Google a yoke of iron. This in the scripture. And see what color the people is that's rocking them, that's wearing them, that's wearing them iron bracelets. It's written in the scripture that he's going to put a yoke of iron upon your neck.
Until he have destroyed you.
And he have totally destroyed the black man and black woman. He has given you his last name. When you give somebody your last name, it denotes ownership. Just like when you take a wife, it says you get a possession. That wife takes your last name. This is my possession. Same thing that your enemy has put on you. And now we run around proud talking about, I'm a Jones. Can't nobody mess with the Joneses, with the Clarks. Israelites.
We deal with the true science. True. You know, okay. Go ahead, brother. Islam is the truth?
Nah, absolutely not.
The truth? Okay, hold on, come here.
Come dialogue with us.
Let's dialogue.
The Christianity.
We don't deal with Christianity.
Okay, but Christ.
Christianity. Christ, right? No, it don't really mean that. It means it's a cretin. It means to be stupid and ignorant.
But get him the surface level.
Why are you falling on that then? Why are you falling on that?
I just told you we're not Christians. Well, have you saw a Christian just like us before?
No.
Absolutely not, because we're not Christians.
Y'all
we're not, but we're not Muslims.
Okay, what are y'all?
We are Hebrew Israelites.
Right.
We are from the seed of Abraham,
so
Isaac,
y'all
and Jacob.
Yahweh.
We follow Yahuwah.
Yahweh. Yeah, Yahweh.
Yeah, Yahuwah.
Okay.
You say it right. Practice it one time with me. Yahuwah. Say it one time with me.
But
he says specifically, the Messiah, the one they call Christ, was sent to the children to deliver the children of Israel from the pale-faced nations. So he knew. Hold up, Yahushua Ali knew something.
That's right.
He knew that we was Israel, brother. He realized that the one they call Christ was sent to deliver us.
Okay, but still, going to Christianity, Christ means what? Christ-like, right?
It's Greek. That term means, supposedly mean anointed.
Anointed.
And then if there's the surface, they say Christ-like or following Christ. But like my sister said, you dig deeper and you need something totally different. Right? So, but again, no new brother.
I know. That's why I'm calling you to teach it.
But
he was awesome. I need you to name me one of those questions out of that 25. Name them. Just give us one.
What? Out of the
7 questions,
give us one of the questions.
Yeah, give us one of the questions out there. Let's see if we want to study it.
It's been a while, brother. Let's be honest.
Okay.
I'm going to tell you. What did he say? When you're out of danger, I'm out of danger right now. So I don't remember. Of course, the one question he said,
The fact of the matter, the brother was up under the Islamic banner, right? He believed in Islam. Right, but let me just read this portion to you out of the Quran, right? He based his Quran, that seventh circle, off the truth. Because if you remember reading your book, I understand, because he developed his own because he wanted to have his own following. But in his own book, he said that at one time he was Muhammad. You remember reading that?
Yeah.
He said one time he was Jesus.
He said he was Buddha. He was all the prophets of the day.
Exactly.
How
can he be all that?
Because he was reincarnated into all the individuals.
Brother, reincarnation is a pagan doctrine.
You think so?
I know so.
You don't believe that you can come back and start all over again with Allah? Absolutely not. Show me somebody.
Listen to one scripture.
Because God said, Allah said, he wants all his children to become one with him, right?
That's true.
Okay, now, only way you, because he knows it's sin out here.
True,
right? So, if you die, he wants you to reincarnate and start it all over again. Get it right with him.
Read that scripture loud and clear.
Hebrews 9, chapter 9 and verse 27. And as it is appointed unto men once to die.
Hold up. It's appointed to men to die. What?
Once.
To die once. But what?
Okay, but.
But
listen, after this judgment.
After that
okay,
judgment.
What mean,
you only
you
get
say
one
judgment,
time.
What do you mean judgment?
Brother, when
so
you put
dealing
to death.
With, you dealing with something dealing with Christianity.
That ain't Christianity.
That's not no Christian book. Okay, but let's see what real Islam say, brother. Okay, hold on. Now, but how can you say you're under Islam when that's the fundamental Islam? I'm gonna read it to you anyway. This is
Surah chapter 2, verse 47. It says, O children of Israel, call to mind the special favor which I bestowed upon you, and that I preferred you to my message. It shows right here, brother. The Quran is even pointing. You got to get back to the book. Even in the Quran, it tells you this. Read it again, because you're trying to get away from it. O children of Israel, call to mind the special favor.
That special favor to who?
Which I bestowed upon you.
Read.
And that I preferred you to all others for my message.
I prefer you to all others.
And remember, we gave Moses the scripture.
Do what?
Hold on, listen. Okay, listen to this.
Listen to this.
This represents Islam right here. It says, remember, we gave Moses.
We did what?
We gave Moses the scripture and criterion between right and wrong.
Of course. He got everybody. Your will to give you the will of choose. Ain't no such thing. You right or wrong. You make your own up here, right here. Right here. Absolutely not. That's why you're running. Shalom, brother. But you're running.
And you couldn't even give us one question out of what you believe. Bananas. Isaiah chapter 34 and verse 16. Seek you out of the book.
Do what?
Seek you out of the book of the Most High. And read. No one of these shall fail.
None of this ain't going to fail, read.
None shall want her mate.
They ain't going to want this. They don't want this mate. Because it's not proper. We get it all out of this book right here. Not this.
For my mouth it has commanded, and his spirit it has gathered them.
So you see where that truth come out, what always happened? the feet get the beating. We get the running. Shalom, brother. Y'all got any questions? How you doing? You got any questions, bro? You see anything? We'll pick up where we left off at.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 54. So that the man that is tender among you.
So that the man is what?
Tender among you.
So that the man that is tender, meaning young man that is among you. Now notice the actions of our young brothers, how they act toward each other. It's always beef. Look at world stars, always folly, some type of foolishness with our young people acting a fool, whether it be man or woman. Read.
His eye shall be evil toward his brother.
His eye shall be evil towards who?
Toward his brother.
His enemy that stay across Akron.
His eye shall be evil toward his brother.
The people that stay across Telegram.
Toward his brother.
Oh, you're only evil towards your own brother. That's what you get your so-called black on black crime, my people. So instead of going out to Bloomfield and hitting them people that really got something, you're going to hit your own brother that stay next door to you. Complete madness, man. Our people is backwards. Go ahead, read.
And toward the wife of his bosom.
And toward the wife of his bosom. Exactly, exactly.
So that the man that is young among you and very delicate, his eye shall be evil toward his brother.
Again, this is where we get our so-called black-on-black crime. Because the scripture already prophesied it thousands of years ago that your eye would be evil towards your own brother. Every day we see this scripture manifested on World Star Hip Hop all day long. It's straight foolishness and folly that our people have befallen us. Read.
And toward the wife of his bosom.
And toward the wife of his bosom. I can't stand that stupid. Let's go ahead, read.
And toward the remnant of his children.
That he gonna do what with?
Which he shall leave.
That's your fatherless children. That's how they set this system up. Now the woman is in the head, and when the woman is the head, it's bound to fall. Because Eve took what? She took the leadership role. And everything has been in shambles since then. The whole world.
So you mean to tell me the woman ain't supposed to lead, brother?
Absolutely not.
So at Cobo Hall right now with them, the Women's Empowerment Expo.
Out of order.
Is what?
Out of order.
Tyler Perry.
Out of order.
Wait a minute. Raheem Devine's performing.
Out of order.
Salt and pepper.
Out of order. Because Tyler Perry does what?
Dress in dresses.
He put on what?
Wigs.
Didn't the scripture say that a man don't wear nothing pertain to a woman? And this brother is doing it and making millions. He got the whole church coming out to the outings. Oh, we going to see Tyler's new movie. Oh, it's so funny. But he's dressing up in a dress. And how these good church folks don't know that, that's out of order. Oh, but in the name of jokes, everything is cool. Absolutely not. Read.
The tender and delicate woman among you, which would not adventure to set her soul upon the ground, her eye shall be evil toward the husband of her bosom.
And that's why you look just like your daddy. Get out of here, nigga. I can't stand you. You look just like... It's already in the scripture. Evil towards him. For nothing. Because he can't provide this TV lifestyle that she's looking at on TV. I want to be like Beverly Hills 902, whatever it is. Falcon Crest or whatever. Read.
Verse 59. Then the Most High will make your plagues wonderful.
He will make the plagues what?
Plagues wonderful.
Then he will make these plagues wonderful. And it's not a good wonderful right here that he's speaking of. Read.
and sore sicknesses.
And sore sicknesses. And you can go across the board. That's why the so-called black man and black woman lead in all categories of sickness. They put it on TV all the time. Blacks are twice as more likely to get diabetes than their white counterparts. It's on TV all day, all the time. Heart, high blood pressure, all of these things. Because we doing what? We eating things that we ought not to eat. He told us, the swine, it's despicable. We're not even to touch its carcass. But what we turn it into, Mark?
A delicacy.
We turn slave food slop that they threw away that wasn't fit for their cows and whatever, and say, you eat it. But now we turn around and made it something great. What a backwards people.
Wait a minute, you mean to tell me having hog maws on New Year's is wrong?
Absolutely. And that's why our women's feet is swollen up. That's why they wobbling when they walk, because you eating something that's detestable. And they told you that when I eat lobster and shrimp, I'm doing something. I'm doing it big. Yes, you're doing your ankles big. Your sugar is rising because you're doing things contrary to what these scriptures speak of. Read.
Also, every sickness and every plague.
Every sickness and every plague. Not a couple of them. Every sickness and every plague. Read.
Which is not written in the book of this law.
So guess what? AIDS is not written in this law. Cancer is not written in this law. But it's coming on our people on a daily. But it's coming on our people daily. All of these things, just like it's written in the scripture.
Verse 61. Also, every sickness and every plague which is not written in the book of this law, then will the Most High bring upon you until you be destroyed.
Until you be destroyed. But they make your death slow. Instead of just giving it to you all out, we're going to put you on pills and keep you messed up for 30 years because they can make more money out of it. Pharmaceutical. Drugs. This is what our people is doing and not even knowing it. When your child is first born and you take and you get them the wicked shots, you don't even know you're putting a death sentence on your people when you're doing this. Because there's nowhere in the scripture that says to give your child a vaccine. Where did that come from? Who created that? Who started it? When we know anything that's new, it's at its best condition. So when a baby is born, its immune system is brand new. So why in the world do you need to go and inject the baby with some poison, with the disease? Come in and get a flu shot. I'm going to give you the flu so you don't get the flu. What type of foolishness is that? The only people that fall for this garbage. I'm going to give you polio so you don't get polio. Our people is backwards as all outdoors. Read.
Verse 64. And the Most High shall scatter you among all people.
He shall do what?
Shall scatter you among all people.
Now last time I checked how all the other nations got over here, they chose to come over here. They wanted to come over here. But how did we get over here, my aunt?
In the bottom of cargo slave ships.
So it wasn't on the cruise line?
Absolutely not. Wasn't the Carnival cruise.
So we didn't come over here by choice. We was drug over here against our will, but everybody else came over here because they can make a meal ticket out of you. Just like it says, the strangers that's among you shall get high. And that's what they do, and they come over here and make merchandise of you. Read.
And the Most High shall scatter you among all people from the one end of the earth to the other.
From the one end of the earth unto the other. So we have been scattered to the four corners of the globe. Wherever people are, the so-called black man and black woman is there. From the tribe of Judah, Benjamin and Levi. Read.
And there you shall serve other gods.
You shall do what?
Serve other gods.
You shall serve other gods. Now we're the only people that's this backwards. We see that these people hung us in trees, beat our backs in, chopped our feet off, cut our hands off, did all of these wicked things to us. And we turn right around and they put up a guy with blonde hair and blue eyes and say, this is your God. Worship him. One day, he's going to get you out of the stuff that you've been put in. Does that make any sense whatsoever? Makes no sense. The same people that brought you over here and beat you to a pulp, guess what religion they followed?
Christianity.
And so we're going to turn around and be what they are. Makes absolutely no sense. We read the Bible, but we're not Christians. We are Hebrew Israelites.
That's right.
This is not a religion. It is a nationality. It's your heritage, your culture, everything about you.
Right. So the Messiah wasn't a white man?
Absolutely not. His head and his hairs were white like wool, and his feet like fine brass as if it burned in a furnace. He was a so-called black man. And that's how he gonna return. Read.
Verse 65. And among these nations shall you find no ease.
So you do what?
Find no ease.
Among these nations. Because he just told us that he was scattering us to the four corners of the globe. So among these nations, plural, you will find no ease. Read.
Neither shall the sole of your foot have rest.
Neither shall the sole of your foot have rest. And we know everybody, most of all of us, is living check to check. Barely can get by no matter what. Because soon as you get a little money, you're going to try to live that American lifestyle and you're going to go spend more money than you got. Soon as they give you the little stimulus check, you're going to say, oh, I got $500. The TV only costs $700. So I can take the $500 they just gave me, put it with the two, and go get that big TV. And then you get your house broken too. Oh, man, we're backwards people. Read.
Verse 66. And your life shall hang in doubt before you.
Your life shall hang in doubt before you. Always scared. Always worried. As soon as them lights pop on that car behind you, you scared as I don't know what. Oh my God. Whether it be from them or your own brother, the young man that's around you, you scared for your life. Read.
Verse 68. And the Most High shall bring you into Egypt again with ships.
So the Most High shall bring you into Egypt again with planes,
with ships.
With, how did you get over here? How did our people get here?
Again, the bottom of cargo slave ships.
Wow, so he wrote this in the book way back then that we was gonna go into captivity in the bottom of ships. You tell me this book ain't right. Again, this don't fit nobody else. Everybody else chose to come here. But we was brought kicking and screaming. It was so bad, some of our people jumped off the side. And they would rather drown and be eaten by sharks than to come over here in this hellhole and live this madness, this nightmare that our people have been living for the last 400 years.
What, it ain't the American dream, brother?
But, hey, when they tell you it's the American dream, you gotta be sleep the dream. And even if you're not asleep, then you're daydreaming. You're still in a state of sleep. Read.
There
there.
You shall be sold to your enemies.
Sold to your friends.
Sold to your enemies.
So it sounds like you're on an auction block or something, right?
Uh-huh.
So they do this every time they have the so-called draft. They put our people on the block and say, look at this fine stud. He's a fine specimen.
About 6'8".
He's about 6'8". He can run this fast. All of his teeth is there. He has good upbringing. He can make it lots of pups. But they give him some fiat money, some paper. And our people fall for it wholesale. There's nothing new under the sun. Now they make you do it, they give you a couple of pieces of paper. When if LeBron and them were smart, they would say, give me gold. But they not, because they are part of it. We
there. You shall be sold to your enemies for bond men.
For slave men.
And bond women.
And slave women. Exactly what happened when they brought us over here. You were sold to your enemy. But we got to address you. How you doing, sir? What's your name? Ulysses Davis. Nice, it's nice to meet you, brother. I'm Quab. My art so far. We're the chosen seed. You got any questions? Anything you want us to answer out this Bible?
I'm in my Bible.
Okay. So do you realize that you are the children of Israel, that you are one of the chosen people, that Moses, so-called, the one that the world calls Jesus Christ, looked like you? Yeah, okay, we're aware of that. Beautiful thing. Yo, shalom, Mark. What's good?
It's okay. Good.
But you got any questions?
I'm just an inquirer.
What, well? Inquirer?
Yeah, I'm a journalist.
Yeah, you're a journalist. Okay. You got a YouTube page or something? So, okay.
Freelance,
all right. What you doing, a documentary or something about Detroit or something? Or what's happening?
I admire the approach that you are taking to understand this black people.
Okay.
Considering that us as black men,
okay,
taking a stand. I'm from Indianapolis.
Okay.
It's wild right there now.
Okay. Indianapolis wild right now?
Too wild, man.
Okay. What's going on there?
It's killing everybody.
Right.
For no reason. People carrying guns. Raising
the
kids, all that stuff, man.
Okay. All that stuff we talking about, right?
Same stuff, but different religion. But, like, we can all be bipartisan about everything.
Well, in all reality, we don't deal with the political side of it, but the thing is, like, what we bringing out is showing our history recorded as prophecy. So, just like you were saying, there's a lot of stuff going on in Indianapolis. A lot of brothers getting killed here left and right. Chicago done lost their darn mind, right? But this, all these things are written of in the scriptures. So it ain't got nothing to do with no religion. We don't represent religion. We represent the fact that we are the true children of Israel according to scripture and history. And all these things was prophesied to happen to us. You know what I'm saying? So again, that bypasses any religious aspect. It's the fact of the matter that we don't even know who we are. And everything we dealing with in Indianapolis and all the cities across the United States and the world written of right here in the book. That's one of the greatest secrets that they keep from us. So.
Because we've always been packed, just like if you look up that term, ghetto. Of all across the so-called United States and the world, it's going to say that it's some certain people that live there. Is somebody getting that? So we're going to show you that this is no coincidence. Because we're telling our people that we are these people that's written of in these scriptures. That's written up in the Bible. In the Bible it calls, in the English Bible it's called Jews. So we're going to look up this term ghetto and see who lives there. And we know it ain't them people out with them black suits and the curly hair on the side. We know it ain't them. So we're going to get this term and show you something. Somebody get it. Pull up one of them Android joints. Super duper smart, all seeing iPhones.
See, all these things are happening because there's no shorter man than no people.
Absolutely.
It's like you said, last would be last would become first, and first would become last. It's talking about the women and the men. You're right. Right at the time, the men's are last, the women's are first. But in the future, women's are coming last, and men's coming first. It's like you said a while ago. It said, you know, don't follow man. God gave Adam the leadership. Moses was the leader.
Okay.
So you got to follow who? God's way of saying, the way he put it.
Right.
You know, you might hear some preachers say, don't follow man. Well, when Jesus was on earth, he was a man.
Right.
And right here, the young lady, I was watching a movie last night. They were trying to find the contact and the connection between her and Christ. They wonder why did they make her a disciple. Martha was a woman and a disciple. Christ was the leader. And they wonder why did they sit her at the table with him? Because they were
Are you talking about that the painting with the Last Supper painting? Right. But again, that honestly, that comes out the Renaissance period where them Romans was actually playing games.
Right.
Leonardo da Vinci actually painted his lover on that joint. There wasn't no woman on there.
See, this is the way we are living in today's world.
True.
Too many men are behind women instead of the man having the woman behind.
We agree 1,000%. Let me read this definition real quick to get on. It says, a part of a city in which members of a particular group or race live. So, look at the ghettos. Like you said, you from Indianapolis, right?
Yes, sir.
We're from Detroit. All of this that's around us is what? The quote-unquote ghetto. Hmm?
What is it up to us?
A quarter of a city in which Jews were formerly required to live. Well, guess what? Most of us can't afford to go to the other place. It says required to live, but it usually say it was forced to live there. So it's even telling you in their definition, even though they didn't modify it to try to take it out because they realize we actually know that it's in there. So the quote-unquote Jews are forced to live in ghettos. Forced to live in ghettos. So it's even in their own wicked literature, their own definitions, telling you who it is. So, you got any more questions, comments?
It's just
It's your mission statement.
What's my mission statement?
Yes, sir.
Our goal is to get into the kingdom. And the only way you do that, you got to keep his laws, statutes, and commandments. Get that Ecclesiastes 12.
You got to get in that word.
Absolutely. It's a must. Ecclesiastes 12 and 13. Y'all got it? Come on with it.
Keep up the good work. Okay. You got enough. Don't have enough.
Ecclesiastes chapter 12 and verse 13. Huh? Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. What's the conclusion? That's the end of something. It's not the beginning. So it says, let us hear the conclusion, the end, read. Fear the Most High. Fear the Most High and do what?
And keep His commandments.
And do what?
And keep His commandments.
And keep His commandments. Why?
For this is the whole duty of man.
Half the duty.
For this is the whole duty of man.
You can do it if you feel like it.
This is the whole duty of man.
This is the whole duty of man, is to fear the Most High and to keep His commandments. Give me Revelations 22:14. Revelations 22:14, we're like the precept.
Who y'all call yourself?
We are the chosen seed. Chosen seed, the chosen seed.
Revelations chapter 22 and verse 14. Blessed are they that do His commandments.
Blessed are they that do His commandments. The same people that he just saw over there in the other chapter. The whole duty of man is to keep the commandments. Now he tell you, blessed are they that do them. So obviously, you gotta be cursed if you don't do them. Read.
Blessed are they that do his commandments.
Read on.
That they may have the right to the tree of life.
That they may have right to the tree of life. So if you don't keep it, you don't have right to the tree of life. Hold on a sec.
So how do you guys differ? I mean, you're reading from the Bible. Like, people can go to church, but like, they hear an inspiring minister. So how do you guys differ from the church?
Well, we're not giving no inspiring nothing. We ain't whooping, we ain't hollering, we ain't charging, we don't got no music playing, and we're actually reading from the Bible. We didn't sit up here and open us. We didn't do like Joel Goldstein and say, this is my Bible. In it, I will do all of this stuff, and I will say something, and then put it down and walk in the front and give you some type of story. We're directly reading the scriptures out of it. Christian pastors don't do that.
Significance of you guys' attire.
We're going back to our original culture. Even though mine is in the car, we're going back to our original culture. And we're getting out of this Greek way of life. That's the whole thing, to get back to what we did before they brought us here. So we got to learn who were we before we was brought here. What was our name before they brought us here? Who were we? How did we eat? How did we walk, talk? All of these type of things. Before they brought us here.
Finish it out.
Blessed are they that do his commandments, that they may have the right to the tree of life, and may enter in through the gates into the city.
That they may enter into the gates through the city. So it says, blessed are they that do his commandments. Go to Genesis 3. I mean, we're really all about, like, success. It says, speaking to the wind. So it's only a couple of people that's going to actually hear what we're speaking. So we ain't worried about numbers. It's our job to tell you. It's not our job to convince no one.
So you guys are out to win souls.
We are out to win souls, but it's not, we can't make anybody come into it. So you walked over here on your own. All of those people over there, they hear it. It's up to them if they choose to come over and get it.
That's right.
So it's not our job. We our job to tell you, but not to convince you.
Last question. If there was a verse that you would say to people that resonate to them, like as a last verse that you could give, what would it be?
Go back to that verse we read. Ecclesiastes 12.
That modifies what represent, AKA right now, in spite of all the turmoil we live in, as black men.
Exactly. We're going to read it again, because this is it. This is our duty. This is our job. It's real simple. Read.
Ecclesiastes chapter 12 and verse 13. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter.
This means the end. Conclusion is end. Read.
Fear Yahuwah.
And do what?
And keep his commandments.
Fear the Most High and keep his commandments. Read.
For this is the whole duty of man.
This is the whole duty. All of this other filth and garbage they put out here and tell you that's not even enough time in the day. Right here he says, fear the Most High, keep his commandments, because this is what?
The whole duty of man.
This is the whole duty of man. I'm sure you're going to see it.
I agree with the message.
You got some flowers?
You're just right. You ain't deviating from the tactics that the Lord laid above us to follow, to reach the promised land. Like, we are all sons of Abraham. So,
absolutely.
I've never seen them like this. As a visitor, I appreciate God at least allowing me to record it too. Nothing else shared.
I'm pretty sure that now that you ran across us, you're going to run into it in your city again. It's not in vain that you came over here.
As active as it is like this. They talk about it, but people don't take a stand, though. And they don't have the will to actually, like, stand out here instead of doing it Saturday night like most niggas. making me make promises. I appreciate that, because that's kind of shut down. And I'm not recording y'all to exploit you or anything. I'm recording y'all because I want to share with people that sense minds with my saying.
Well, we pray that when they see the chosen seed, they convicted in themselves to get out and do the same work. They can contact us, you know what I'm saying? So get somebody's information, man.
And I love that you're not just inside the church, you're actually in the street.
Right, because he told us to hit the highways and byways.
Because people in my city, all they do is preach to the same church. And they ain't really, they talk about like,
tithes and offerings, that's all it's about. Tithes and offerings, good pay.
Appreciate
it. Shalom, bro.
What's
up, bro?
Abraham too was black. Abraham born in the city of a black man, called Nimrod, grandson of Ham. Ham had four sons. One was named Canaan. Here, let me do some explaining. Abraham was the father of Isaac. Isaac was the father of Jacob. Jacob had 12 sons, for real, and these were the children of Israel. According to Genesis chapter 10, Egyptians descended from Ham. 600 years later, my brother, read up. Moses was born in Egypt.